This is the largest test article ever built with the curved path. The name of this project is the Passive Aeroelastic Tailored Wing. We call it the PAT wing because it's easier to say.
Minus 30 on 4, leading edge.
There are several differences between this wing and a traditional wing. First of all, it's built out of composites. Some of the newer aircraft that we see being built in commercial transports are built out of composite. But it's different from those, not only in the shape, the geometry, the length and the width and thickness, but also the biggest difference is in the skins. We're actually steering the composite fibers. With this particular design, we're trying to tailor that stiffness. And so instead of going straight along the wing, we're actually curving that fiber in the plane of the wing so that we can change the stiffness along the full length.
This was one of the most heavily instrumented wings we've ever tested. There was about 10,000 sensors on a wing, which included fiber optic strain sensing, conventional strain sensing, displacement sensors, load sensing, and also inclinometers.
Surface prep, bonding, wiring, checkout. So there's quite a bit that does go into it.
For the last 4 years or so, the wing was fabricated by Aurora in Mississippi, and the wing was brought here over the last 6 months. We integrated it into our test fixture.
We used a hydraulic load control system to apply load at 7 stations along the wing.
Pressure is up 4 trillion.
Just figuring out where we need to be at the right angles so that we can see the targets.
Each camera bar has 2 cameras on it in stereo, so it's giving us a 3-dimensional position of each of those targets.
You verify alignment and do it also. Let me get your figure here.
In future transports, we see the wings are getting larger, longer, and thinner for aerodynamic benefits, mostly for drag reduction. And so the challenge is when wings get longer and thinner, they become more flexible. And so the intention of this particular test was to try to control that flexibility to allow us to still build a lightweight wing with the structural benefits and enable the aerodynamic benefits simultaneously.
Because this wing was going to see large displacements under load, we designed a special loading system that included both underwing loading and overwing loading.
The length of the wing is 39 feet, and the tip is projected to deflect on the order of 8 feet.
Go ahead and start the load profile.
The testing lasted for a couple weeks. Typical positive upload test took approximately an hour. And that data and sensors collected at 100 hertz or 20 hertz, depending on the type of sensor, will be collected, and we will take that and analyze that over the next 6 months.
We hope that this will find its way into commercial market. You know, this is really the first step to demonstrate that it's not only feasible, but then, you know, give us a path towards being able to certify the technology so that it can be used in commercial aircraft.